Hey folks, this is Best in Slot, and welcome back to the Dominion Biosyn expansion for Jurassic World Evolution 2. We're finally going to get started with the campaign today. We're going to play through the first mission. Maybe I'll take a couple of videos, we'll see. But either way, the entire thing will go up today. Then we can finally start tackling the second mission, the one I haven't seen before. I've just heard rumours about what might be in it. Of course, I have played this first mission before for my pre-release footage, but I kind of had to focus on, you know, getting through to the dinosaurs as fast as possible. So now we should hopefully be able to enjoy the whole thing a little bit more. Don't think I've got anything else to say. It's very hot today, by the way. I am dying. Right, let's get started.
As John Hammond realized his vision for Jurassic Park, his competitors began to see the potential of InGen's work. One of their main rivals, Biosyn, looked to close the gap by stealing the advantages that InGen and Dr. Wu had worked so hard to gain. To do this, they would need someone on the inside. So they enlisted a disgruntled computer engineer named Dennis Nedry. A plan was devised to steal InGen's dinosaur embryos with an inconspicuous canister created to house the precious commodity. Nobody really knows what happened that fateful night. What is certain is that Dennis Nedry and the samples were never seen again. Biosyn had failed. Unfortunately, so too had Hammond's dream. Decades later, businessman Simon Mizrani tried again, this time succeeding in delivering Hammond's vision to the world. Tragically, things didn't go as planned. Biosyn was waiting for its time, and they found it in the aftermath of Jurassic World's downfall. Now, led by Lewis Dodgson, a new era was dawning. While we don't know what the future holds, history has a habit of repeating itself.
Honestly, I think that's one of the best ones. I don't know how they do them. It's really impressive. It's clearly a mix of film footage and also they are doing 3D renders. But taking the film footage and integrating it into that style blows me away every single time. It really does. I'm very easily impressed.
Just look at it. It's beautiful. We are so close to realizing Biosyn's dream. One that InGen could never achieve. Once we get dinosaurs here, it will be perfect.
A perfect display of evolution.
Luck favors the bold. We were prepared. Now we need to finish the job. Give me the latest on the animals.
We're isolated, which makes for a challenging landscape. We are still at a disadvantage until we understand more about this ecosystem and how our new friends will adapt to it.
We need more information and time. The last thing we want is for them to not adapt and die.
Oh, they'll adapt. I believe that. They adapted to two parks and a few islands. They're adapting now. They'll be just fine. Just get them here.
I'm not sure we are totally ready to understand everything we need to.
Just get them here. Leave the rest up to Mother Nature and me.
Ba-da-bum. I have many things to say, but I have to wait.
I guess what they say is true. It's location, location, location.
More than you realize. This is perfect. Keeps us away from the public's prying eyes, and keeps the political do-gooders at arm's length.
To think what InGen had and fumbled away. They never saw the bigger picture.
All dinosaur and zero business.
That is where Biosyn wins. We bring a balance that InGen never understood. We see the whole picture.
Okay, what's our next step? I don't want to waste any time getting this going.
Well, it all starts with a control center.
Remember, it needs to be connected to the Hyperloop network.
All right then. Get started.
Okay, several comments to make. Number one. I can't remember. Number one, I don't know. Is it? I mean, can I give spoilers for Dominion now? It's been out for a while. Let's just say the thing about the Barbasol can isn't necessarily true anymore. Let's say that much. So there's that. Number two, Ramsey Cole. I thought it might change. I noticed this in my pre-release thing, but he sounds like he's recording it via remotely. I don't think he came into the studio like everyone else did, if you just listen to his voice quality.
Everything's in place for us to get our new research compound constructed.
Great. Then we can focus on getting it operational.
You see what I mean? He's got this kind of echo and tinny quality to his voice. It's okay quality, but it's clearly not... It's nowhere near Isaac in particular. It's not really any nearer... Dodson either. Third thing, they're going on about how InGen didn't combine business and dinosaurs, but Masrani absolutely did. And it was still an abject disaster. So, you know, they're an optimistic sort anyway. We'll see how that goes for them. Power!
Isaac, update?
Everything is going to plan. We should have the research we need shortly.
Great. Carry on.
So I obviously played this before I ever saw the film. I played this way before the film came out. I played this weeks ago. And I thought Dodson sounded super weird. He's super understated, super chill, and then he's actually like that in the film as it happens. I actually really, really liked him in the film. So it's quite cool to have that kind of different style of villain, I think. One who's a little bit more relaxed rather than Mills in the last film, who just needed a big evil mustache, really.
Okay, that did it. We have access to the core facilities research.
Great. Our vision is coming together if each building we get operational.
We just need to ensure we can handle all the dinosaurs when they arrive.
I think we can do that.
It's all starting to come together, just as we envisioned. We are leaving InGen in our dust.
Well, I will give them some credit. They did resurrect the dinosaurs from extinction.
Sure, through a rushed agenda and lazy science. We're doing it right. Their failures were our education. We won't be making the same mistakes Hammond and his team made. InGen always fell in love with their own wonder. They wanted to prove to the world that they could do it. Once they did, they wanted to showcase them as circus freaks and rub our faces in it. They didn't get it. Evolution is not just DNA and frogs. It also happens in business, to advance the world. Think of what we will bring to the world. Think of what we will bring to humanity. New medicines, biotechnology, beauty products, you name it, we will own it.
Well, if there's one thing the world needs more of, it's beauty products.
I want to see a functioning facility. That is the only way we can secure the dinosaur survival.
Absolutely, we'll get it done.
See that you do. A lot is riding on it.
You see what I mean? He sounds a bit weird, doesn't he? No offense, Ramsey. It's not your fault, buddy. I don't have any power down here. Am I just going to put a thing in? I'm just going to put a thing in. Rather than having to screw up my building. And we need a emergency shelter. Just in operatives. And then we're going to need a power thing as well. Little repeater substation. That should attach into there nicely. Oh, there we go. Just about. I'm not going to screw up quite so badly this time. Or at least that's the idea. I mean, that's always the idea, I suppose, isn't it? You're never like, well, you know what, today I might screw up. You know, yeah, I'm just in the mood. I'm in the mood to look like I can't play the game. What can I say? I'm a wild card. Come on, buddy, you're the last holdout. Who's a good girl? Who's a good girl?
I am! We're authorized to expand our team. Specifically, scientists. Look over the candidates and let's add some to our operation.
Let's do it. Ooh. Good old generalist. Love a generalist. I need someone who's got a bit more logistics. Not you, you're a numpty. Someone who's got three logistics. No, fine, that'll do. I need people with points and other things. Yeah, okay. Who have we got here? We've got Alvarado, Williams,
hey,
Jabal,
I have
and
Matsui. Exciting news. We're closing in on some exclusive biosyntech. Invisible fencing. It'll secure the animals while removing the traditional man-made constructs that have surrounded their environments.
So, no visible barrier between us and the dinosaurs? That sounds terrifying.
The more these animals believe they are not in cages, the healthier they will be.
Yeah, that will make them easier to care for.
I think We'd better place some research outposts as well. We can observe our animals safely from there.
You know, it's bad enough that dinosaurs never knew what a fence was until we placed them around them. But what if they become dependent on them to feel safe? At least they could see a barrier between us and them. How are they even going to trust their environment with invisible fences? How are they even going to know where they are?
Oh, believe me, they'll feel it if they try to cross one.
Yeah, that. I don't know. Look, it feels like we're messing with them and how comfortable they'll be in their environment.
You're concerned about fences? The dinosaurs never saw a human before either, and that hasn't stopped us.
Oh, Isaac, never change.
Isaac, we've got an issue. We're in need of more power.
How close are we to maximum output?
Already there. We won't be able to hold much longer.
Then we'll need to research how to get more. Upgraded power stations is the way forward. Let's get to it.
Zoom in. Where's my power? There it is. Apologies if I'm going too fast every now and again, but we have seen this before, so... Right.
Before we go any further, there's something I want from you. Through my connections, I've arranged for a number of dinosaurs to be delivered here to our facility. They're coming all the way from Isla Sorna, so you'll have some time to prepare for their arrival. I'm confident you won't let me down.
They're going to need enclosures, secure enclosures. Safety is essential for them and us.
And we have to get this right. We don't need another InGen or Masrani incident.
Absolutely. We will do better.
I wonder if they can live together. I never really thought about this last time. I'm going to check when the Segos get here. See what they can live with without wanting to murder each other. That'd be nice. I think they may all be able to go one habitat, honestly. I think last time I made three separate habitats, which in retrospect was utterly nonsense. So, let's see what we can do this time. Okay, we need some more stuff. We need a gate. What do we need? We don't need a gate. Gates are a trick, because your ranger vehicles can actually just drive over this gap. They can just drive over the invisible fence without a problem. We do need... Well, the game's going to tell me to build one of those in a minute. We need a ranger outpost, however. This might be too small, but... Need to rename our team. They are the drive bobies, of course. As they have been for a long time now. Drive bobies. Oh, and the fly girls. There we go. These invisible fences take ages to build. Reminder, by the way, that I absolutely adore this map from the bottom of my heart.
Commencing asset transit. Asset transportation underway.
Okay, let's see how we're doing here. Just want to check their... I'm pretty sure the galley can live with either of them. It's more whether the Sego and the Parrot can live together that I'm curious about. Come on, down you pop. Yeah, we're okay. Okay, cool. So yeah, we're gonna put them all together. Sounds like a plan. Right, let's get a little bit of water. A little bit of ground fiber. They'll be fine on forest, just need to extend their territory a little bit. Ground fiber? Oh god, they need ground fiber and ground fruit. You're a cheeky little blighter, aren't you? Nearly. And then that'll hit that in a second. Yeah, cool. Easy peasy. Nice natural habitat. Okay, didn't mean to do that. Show me Gallimimus. Thank you. Gallimimus, as some people are prone to calling it. Those people are bad people. Just in case you're curious, those are what we call bad people. They're not to be trusted. Are they? No. So yeah, I don't know how long this is going to take. Last time it took me an hour and 45 minutes, but I was done in about an hour and a quarter. And then obviously I had to hang around because I wanted to make my Therizinosaurus and Giganotosaurus fight each other. We don't even need the Therizinosaurus and the Giga, technically. And we're probably not going to make them in this campaign mission because I'm assuming they're part of the next one. Although, as I say, I haven't seen the next campaign mission. What am I patterning? Hello, lovely. This is the same patterning as the... It is there in the original Jurassic Park, it's just not the most prominent one. I think it's meant to be a juvenile, or at least a younger galley. Sub-adult. As opposed to a dom-adult. I've messed around my sound settings for the first time in this game in ages. Usually what I have to do, and what I've been doing on Chaos Theory, you'll notice that the game keeps changing volume every time there's a cutscene. What I do is I manually go in and find every single time that someone talks, and I manually adjust the volume upwards for that specific segment. And it's, as it sounds, pretty bloody annoying to do. So, this time I've lowered the game volume in general and kept the voice volume at max, and I'm hoping it's going to strike that perfect balance where I don't need to go and edit every single bloody thing. Parasaurs! You happy galley? No, you need ground leaf. Why do you all need different things? That's very silly.
Asset has been collected.
We can make them all happen. I'm pretty sure we can do this. You're still content. You're content just waiting on the paras now. Who are paraing in. It's kind of like Godzilla. It's not at all like Godzilla. What do you need, buddy? If you need something else, I swear to God. What? Oh, we already have Gramnot, don't we? Oh, I don't know if we do. Why have you made...
Delivery complete. Transit
all of them different. That's very obnoxious.
Looks like the enclosures are ready.
We need to make these habitats as desirable for the dinosaurs as we can.
They're missing forests, but they won't be for long. Just need him to walk around a little bit. There we go.
Ramsey, I've been going through the data, and I think we can make some real progress if we get a research outpost connected to our Hyperloop.
Yeah, makes sense to me.
Awesome. Then let's make it happen.
Without proper security, we slip into the same chaos that brought down our rivals. But our ranger team should be capable of maintaining order.
We'll set up the necessary patrols.
Yeah, I don't have to remind you, remote monitoring can only go so far.
Of course. We'll get right on it.
Smashing this. I'm gonna give you a little break after this.
You are victims of your own success? Because, gentlemen, that's where you find yourselves. Both of you.
Not sure I follow.
It means we're doing our job, so we can take on even more.
Whatever the challenge, we're ready.
Then welcome to the Biosyn Genetics Research Compound Phase 3. This will allow us to continue expanding our genetic engineering division and take our operations to the next level. Biosyn is counting on you. More importantly, I am counting on you.
We need perfect genetic samples for the best outcome. That is something Biosyn will write a check for.
Yeah, but we're not yet in control. We're dependent on others until we get in a position to send out our own expeditions. And I don't like being unable to control the outcome of something.
Yes, but once this research is done, we'll be able to send out our own expeditions. We should be in a better place around our samples.
If we own and control it, it's better for Biosyn. And you.
That moon is zooming. Absolutely zooming.
Okay, we are ready to build an expedition center.
Don't forget, we'll need a fossil center too.
Understood.
These buildings will put Biosyn at the cutting edge of bioengineering.
Absolutely zooming, that moon. It's the frickin' Majora's Mask situation going on here. Right. Power over there. Hopefully I did this correctly. I wanted those to be about equal.
It's a lot neater this time. I'm not going to say this is the best laid out park you're ever going to see in your life, but it's neater. At the very least, it's much neater. Yeah, that moon is flying. Also, I really like these. I can't believe I didn't realize these sink down. I just really wish this and the other viewing towers you could move around.
My understanding is that you're ready to send out a team?
That's correct.
Good. I want you to start with an amber mining expedition. This valley wasn't chosen by accident. This area is rich with amber. And I intend for Biosyn to exploit that. Insects trapped in prehistoric tree sap. That is what we need.
This is where our dinosaurs begin.
This amber is going to be the time capsule that links us back to the era of the dinosaurs.
It's a window to the past, and worth billions. Ramsey, have our scientists extract what they can from the fossils. That'll increase our genome diversity.
Yes, on it. And what is the end goal of this?
To do the impossible again.
Yeah, Ramsey. God. Sorry that I'm skipping those tutorial things, but I assume everyone has kind of seen it by now. If not, the Amber Mine's very simple. They're basically the exact same as the regular expeditions. You just happen to go to an Amber Mine, basically, and it has multiple levels that you have to unlock. But really, each map is just like going on a regular expedition. As I said in my semi-review, it would have been nice, I think, to maybe just add something else to the mechanic a little bit. Anyways, what I was also saying, it'd be really nice to be, imagine if you could click show view and then walk around in here. How good would that be? In like a little first person view and just walk around in this area. That'd be a really nice touch, I'm just saying. So what are you doing? I didn't tell you to do this. It's got a mind of its own. I'm not gonna see any bloody dinosaurs if you go up there, you know that. Right, speed up time, nothing's happening. Hang out with our stegos for a little bit. How high's your tail? Nice and high is what I want to see. None of that tail dragging nonsense in my town. Alright, here we go. Boop. When she's finished her rest, I'm going to do a little bit of research. I'd like to upgrade my scientists and then upgrade our expedition capacity. Although we only need the Dimetrodon and the Pyroraptor, I believe. And then there's going to be another delivery as well. Also, there's a fly in my room, and I feel like it's in my headset, because I keep hearing this buzz. And I feel like it's inside my brain, so I'm just going to shake it loose. I don't think it's in my brain, but I have a slight fear about that. You know, like in, what's that horror film with Renee Zellweger and, who's the guy from Limitless? What's he called? Bradley Cooper. Renee Zellweger, and it's like early days Bradley Cooper. And late days of Renee Zellweger.
That's it. We've had a breakthrough. An entirely new genome.
So what you're saying is we've discovered a new dinosaur? One we've never seen before?
Sort of. It is incredible, but it's not actually a dinosaur per se. It's a prehistoric synapsid called Dimetrodon.
Huh. Did Hammond have one of these?
I don't believe so.
Perfect. A Biosyn exclusive.
This DNA is only part of the puzzle, though. We still need to build a hatchery and then synthesize this new breed.
Once we've done that, we can incubate and release them.
I can't wait.
Funny thing is, there's a line in Dominion where Ramsay's talking to Dodson, and he kind of makes... Like, Ramsay's clearly a bit of a dino nerd, and he kind of makes this really... just totally nonsensical remark to Dodson. It's like this big dramatic moment. It's like, well, actually, scientifically, you know, you're wrong. He is paleo Twitter. am I gonna... Yeah, 69%. I'm not gonna turn it down, am I, 69%? That'd be madness. Where's my... So I'm gonna do a little bit more research while we're here. What are we doing with our lives? Let's not get into that now. There we go, that's what I've been looking for. Maybe get this one on the go as well. Oh, beautiful, there we go. Double research, baby. My favourite kind of baby is the double research baby. Now we're looking for maximum egg. I promise, eventually we'll have a maximum egg t-shirt. So you can all show the world how many eggs you enjoy. Which is maximum. No, we didn't get maximum egg. We weren't a million miles away, though. I have to wait for this science to be done. Fun fact. Oh, I should have mentioned, by the way, if any of you watching this have had problems with your game recently, it's been like super flickering and madness. I don't tend to mention this stuff because it won't be true pretty soon, but if that is the case, then what you need to do is roll back your NVIDIA driver. The latest version of NVIDIA driver has basically broken Jurassic World Evolution 2, so just something to keep in mind. I don't think money is a problem on this game mode, so I'm just going to train everyone up. Okay. And we need a ranger post. That effect. What's going on? Ooh. Oh, what was I going to say? Oh, I don't remember. I was going to say really exciting words. I have entirely forgotten. Wow. I genuinely have no idea. What was I going to say? Can't have been that important. It's so hot. Why is it so hot? It's England, for God's sake. It's the north of England. I didn't sign up for this. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, Dimetrodon. Names: Dippy, Donatello, Dimitri, Diamond, Dolores. There we go, there's the gang. You know, I instantly feel more attached to all of these Dimetrodons because I've given them names. It's like quite an important thing that you should do. Right, we need to give them some meat. Diamond needs meat. Yeah, we need sand, water, and forest. That'll obviously get a little bit better automatically, but let's do just that. Trying to emphasize that. Is this sand? No, this is rock. Trying to emphasize that swampy environment that Dimetrodon would have once lived in and loved. There we go. They'll get more forests as they explore, anyway. They'll get more forests as they explore, won't they? Actually, whilst we're here, I'm going to put a cheeky little decoration in. I'm not allowed. I want to put individual trees in. That's all I wanted to do. Oh, well. Alright. Now, you can't say I don't put any effort in my park, so there you go. I created something beautiful. I really can't remember what I was going to say. It feels like it was important as well. It's very annoying.
Thanks in part to your efforts, it's becoming clear that Biosyn will be the home of paleobiology moving forward.
Our future is found in the past.
I like that. Sure, we've had some difficulties, that was expected, but you handled it well. I think we can now move forward with the next phase of Biosyn. We have a world-class operation. Let's take it global. Biosyn will represent the past, present, and future. So, what do we focus on next?
We focus on upgrading our research compound. That'll give us benefits across the board.
I want a crown jewel. Something we can all be proud of. Do the research. We're shooting for 100% complete dinosaur genomes.
The genetic link between birds and dinosaurs has long been established. Now, with a feathered dinosaur, we can finally have our proof.
Yeah, with a living specimen. It's gonna be incredible. Well, what are we waiting for? Time to get started on the research.
There we go. I just needed to bring that area up a little bit. I remember what I was gonna say. So, I said a second ago that I don't need to worry about money, but I went bankrupt last time, and Rudy went bankrupt on his playthrough as well, so I don't know, so I'm not so sure about that. Hello, beautiful. Can I... Yeah... does this work for anyone else? Depth of field, man, never works. Never, ever works. Used to work on evolution, no problem. Does not work on evolution 2. It used to, very briefly. Now it hates me.
Magnificent. Biosyn is at the brink of excellence. Everything InGen aspired to be, and more.
It is truly something. I just...
Just what?
Well, this is the point InGen thought they had everything in place. Then it all unraveled from there.
Yeah, let me put your fears to rest. I am not Hammond. He was all ego. I am not Masrani and his tech-first approach. We are set up to succeed, and that is what we're going to do.
Oh, no, I didn't mean to imply that...
No, no, I understand what you're trying to say. There is truth in it. But we're in a far better position to succeed because others have failed. Hammond and Masrani both brought tremendous advances to the world. They just had a narrow vision of it. We do not. We see the whole picture. We see the balance of it. Where there are advancements, there needs to be a business that supports it.
That makes sense.
Look, Biosyn's not just interested in the dinosaurs. They have the potential to provide improvements for all life on this planet. If we don't jump on this opportunity, someone else will. So why not us?
Why not, Dodson? Why not? Alright, Amber Mine level 2.
We're looking for research on a very specific animal. If I were to say that its name means Olympus Fire Thief...
A pyroraptor?
Yes, exactly.
Before we can proceed any further, we'll need to send a team out for pyroraptor amber samples.
No problem.
It looks like we should be able to achieve a complete, uncompromised genome with the pyroraptor.
That should make Dodson happy.
Let's grab this. What was I going to talk about? Oh yeah, so it's talking about how... Actually, no, I wanted to talk about this. People kind of went on about how Fallen Kingdom set up a new world for Jurassic World, right? It kind of changed everything and, you know, dinosaurs are out there in the wild now and they're all over the place and blah, 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 blah. All this kind of jazz, right? And how things are going to be different. In retrospect, Dominion is basically Jurassic Park. And Lost World, and Jurassic Park 3, and Jurassic World. Like, there's two proper scenes that are like dinosaurs are in the world, and the rest of it is in Biosyn Valley, which is basically the same as Jurassic Park 3, or The Lost World, or any of it, where the dinosaurs just free roam. They talk up this like big, I just realized this, they talk up this big change. And it wasn't any different. It was still a megalomaniac running a park where the dinosaurs were just running around eating everyone. What was the difference, honestly? Am I crazy? I don't think I'm crazy. I think that's a valid point. It's hard. I don't blame them. Don't get wrong. It's tough, man, to come up with another way to have dinosaurs in the world. It really is. It's not an easy thing to do, actually. Because dinosaurs... There's no reason for them to exist anywhere. You know, you need to set up an area for them. You can either do it like this, or you can do it much more wild, or you can do like a time travel kind of thing, or you can do a Lost World kind of thing. You know, like a, not as in Lost World Jurassic Park, but more like a, you know, you discover, you know, it's like that land, but the Hollow Earth and stuff like that. I know it's not dinosaurs, but you know what I mean. Other than that, how else do you integrate dinosaurs into a story? It's actually a very difficult thing to do. They're not an easy thing to sort of bring back, in a way. There's not many valid story reasons to have dinosaurs around, is what I'm trying to say. Anywho, what do I want? What I actually want is... that one, I guess? Do I have something for you? Yeah, that's what we're looking for. I'm not really sure why I'm bothering. To be honest, right, let's speed up time because nothing's going on. Do we need to shoop stuff? Anyone? It's always that you, Williams. You're a good egg, but like I want to upgrade you, and you're constantly the one who's bloody busy. How are we doing, paras? What type of para are we? Just say, we're the Lost World para. We're all sauna dinosaurs here. I'm glad that they brought sauna back, at least. You know. Kind of not doing that whole sauna's been bombed to Hades kind of thing. Not bombed, but destroyed. And people say, ah, they never said that. Yeah, come on, they did, though. Let's be reasonable here. People are retconning a little bit, and that's totally fine. Like, it doesn't have to be a big deal. Why can't we retcon, you know? top tip, the dinosaur you're looking for is always the one on the far left. Not really sure why. I'm gonna give some people a rest whilst that's on the way. Boop. Can I train Williams? I can train Williams! He's the man he was always meant to be. I'm just gonna give all these a rest. If you're gonna rest people, you may as well do it at the same time, right? For efficiency. You know how I love efficiency. How you doing, Dimitri? Look at that. It's beautiful. It really is. This map is so nice. I'm really excited for this next campaign level. I know a little bit of what happens just because it was in the bloody patch notes that I read for my video the other day, but I haven't seen any gameplay from it. I haven't played it myself. I've not seen any screenshots or anything, so it's going to be a really cool new adventure. Whereas this, I'm going to talk a lot of nonsense because I've played this before and it's been on the channel before and yada yada yada. So we are going to relatively zoom through, I would suggest, which hopefully makes sense to people. Right, oh yeah, it does make sense. This is why you upgrade your fossil center, by the way. How much more useful is that? It's amazing. Oh, whatever. And now we must wait for, like... Shouldn't that only be 2 seconds? One hippopotamus, two hippopotamus. I don't think that's right. It's close, but it's not right. Oh, yeah. If I was a pyroraptor, where would I be? I would be dead, apparently. Where's the pyroraptor? So unlock on the first floor as well. It's always on the far left. I don't know if they've done that on purpose. It does seem like they must have done, right? Oh, we should set up the exhibit as well. This is when it gets tricky, because I've kind of like built myself into a corner already. Like, how do I keep this looking okay? I don't know if I can. Oh no, and that's a disaster as well. Oh no. Okay, come down from the straight first. It's better. No, okay, we'll go like this. I just want my angles to be sexy. It's all I'm looking for, is sexy angles, okay? Okay, and then let's get another hatchery. I know I'm kind of wasting money by doing this, but also I like seeing the exit animations, so, you know, what are you going to do? Put that there. If you just do this, if you just do lines and then lines, I'm not going to say it's well made or anything, but it kind of, it just inherently makes everything look a little bit neater, you know? What are we doing? Ba-bum-bum. That should be 100%, I reckon. Yeah, sure is, Scotty. One of you out there will be called Scotty. If you're called Scotty, please let me know in the comment section. We'll be best friends. I've always wanted a friend called Scotty. It's like everyone should have a friend called Dave. Same kind of deal. I don't have a friend called Dave, however, it's worth mentioning. Is that worth mentioning? I don't know, but I've mentioned it now. So I don't have a friend called Dave. So if any of you are called Dave, feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. But you have to be like a lad kind of Dave. That's kind of the whole point of a Dave, right? It's like, oh, it's Dave down the pub, you know? If you're Dave and you're... I don't know. What would non-pub Dave do? If you like the opera. Not that there's anything wrong with liking the opera, but Dave down the pub doesn't like the opera, you know what I mean? Reaching out.